From News 8 WMTW-TV, this is a News 8 Now update.
Good morning and welcome back to News 8 Now. I'm Tracy Sable. The state's governor-elect is about to meet with the president. Paul LePage made headlines during the election with his go-to-hell comment aimed at President Barack Obama. But now he's in the Capitol, where he is set to meet with Obama on Wednesday. Only on News 8, we caught up with LePage Wednesday before his meeting with leaders and the president. And he says he's expecting to address some top priorities.
But as we move forward, and I told the leadership here today that, like many of the other governors, that we need to take a look at K-12 and we need to look at health insurance for our people. We got to keep our people insured, and we got to keep our people healthy, and we got to do it affordably.
The nation's newly elected state's governors are in Washington, D.C. for Democratic and Republican leadership meetings. An update now on the Biddeford High School mold concern. Two classrooms in the school that closed this week because of mold have reopened. An air quality company tested the rooms, which showed the rooms had average levels of mold and that students and teachers could return to the classroom with no risk. A plan is being developed by an environmental specialist from Biddeford, as well as other school and air quality experts, for controlling the air quality for all of the buildings. Now, the fate of an old school in Auburn is at the heart of a debate between the city's mayor and several councilors. 2 weeks ago, the Auburn City Council voted 4-3 to demolish the former Great Falls School, which now houses a dozen businesses, including the Community Little Theater. The mayor thought the council voted in error by suspending their rules. He called for a revote next month, saying they needed a supermajority or 5 affirmative votes. Turns out, the Maine Municipal Association ruled that the original vote will stand. Still, critics are wondering why the city council continues to suspend their rules on a regular basis, 31 times this year. Some are worried it's a way to circumvent public input on major decisions.
That's not true. Whoever told you that is a liar. We do not change the rules. We have had open government in the past 4 years that I've been sitting on this council. And when I got on this council, there were a lot of backroom meetings when I got on it, and it stopped immediately.
In this case, the motion to suspend the rules has been used lately for major decisions. Usually it's done for regular activity type decisions to help the city manager get things moving along. But when you get into major decisions, I feel that the motion to suspend the rules should be used carefully.
The tenants at the old school have been told that they can stay until May. The city plans to move forward with plans to demolish just the section of the school that was the classrooms. The auditorium that houses the theater will remain. Thanks for joining us here on News 8 Now. I'm Tracy Sable. Stay with us for the latest weather and sports highlights. We'll be right back.